Hi and welcome back to the channel. I have received a lot of questions on what is the difference between SAP ECC and SAP S4HANA. And my answer to this question was always that the answer is too long. So today I'm going to tell you in detail how you can find the differences between SAP ECC and SAP S4HANA per module. So if you are working on finance module, you can know the difference. If you are working on materials management, if you are working on sales and distribution, you can know in details the difference between SAP ECC and SAP S4HANA. And I'm also going to tell you how you can find the difference between the different SAP S4HANA versions that have been issued by SAP until now. But before we start, I hope that everyone is staying safe with the circumstances of Corona. I hope that you find the time you spend at home enjoyable and useful. It is not an easy situation, but now we have more time to do things that we didn't have time to do before. So for example, learn something new, try to do some posts on the social media about your career or so. For me, I have always wanted to record an SAP configuration course on Udemy that I never started. I have been delaying it forever. So hopefully this will give me the time to challenge myself and start doing this course. It is a lot of work, so I'm actually very lazy to do, but hopefully I will convince myself to start recording the course now since there is a lot of time and I'm not allowed to go outside as most of the people now. So I hope you find this time useful. I know it is a hard situation, but I hope you find it useful and try to use this time to learn something new. Also, I hope you don't mind the echo in the audio. I have a very weird echo today that I'm not sure how to get rid of. There is no way, to my knowledge, on how to get rid of this echo without spending a lot of money. So I actually don't know. I don't know if you can hear it. I will try to get rid of it in the after production, but hopefully it doesn't annoy you while watching the video. So let's start. Whenever SAP releases a new SAP S4HANA version, they also release a document that's called SAP Simplification List. So this is a PDF format document. It is free for everyone. You can find it on help.sap.com. And this document includes all the updates, all the differences between the old version and the new version. So if you go to the first document, the first simplification document released by SAP when they started SAP S4HANA, you will find the difference between S4HANA and ECC. And then if you go to the newer documents, you will find the differences between every S4HANA version and the newer one. So to do this, all you have to do is to go to help.sap.com and then you search for simplification list. You will find a lot of useful documents. I'm going to focus only on what we need for now. So I'm going to filter on S4HANA. So S4HANA on-premise. And the format I'm looking for is PDF. So I'm going to unselect these and keep only PDF. Now, as you see, we have simplification list for 1709, 1909. There is a lot of them. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to filter here with the version. So if I want to know the difference between ECC and S4HANA, I will go to the first one, 1511. So this is the first simplification list published by SAP. So if you go here, you will find simplification list for SAP S4HANA on-premise edition 1511. So open this document. And here, it is free for everyone. You don't even have to log into the website. So now if I go to the table of contents, for example here, as you see, you have simplification list per application area. So this is what I was telling you about. For every module, you can find the differences. You don't have to go through the whole document. It can be a lot of work, but you can look on the index. And if you find something interesting or related to your project, related to your area, you have to read it. Why? Now, some functions were not available in SAP ECC, and also some other things were available in SAP ECC, but were updated and upgraded in SAP S4HANA. Now, if you don't know what are the applications that have been replaced or what are the new functionalities, you are going to give a wrong solution to your customer. Or if you are someone who has SAP and you are going to convert to SAP S4HANA, then you have to also to know this so you can know what to expect from S4HANA. So for example, if we start by the first one, you have the business partner approach. So this is was the biggest, one of the biggest changes in SAP S4HANA, that we don't have customer master data and vendor master data separate anymore. We have business partners. So if you go to the business partner approach, it will explain in detail what is business partner, what are the transactions that have been replaced. So you cannot go to the normal transactions for ECC, for master data, for customers and vendors now. You have to use the new transaction, which is BP. So now you cannot, so this will explain to you what are the transactions that have been replaced and how it does it work. Let's take a very simple example, because this one I needed in one of the projects. Now, if you look here, so this is all in master data. We didn't even go to the other modules. If you look here to the material number field length extension, this is extremely important. So this is a very simple example. In SAP ECC, the material number field was only 18 digits. In SAP S4HANA, this is 40 digits. It may like sound simple to you, but now imagine a customer that has a very long material number field in ECC. You didn't have a solution. You had to do an user exit or an enhancement or a custom code. Now in SAP S4HANA, it is a standard that you can get the material number field up to 40 digits. So this is important if you go here. So it will explain in detail. So material number field length extension, on-premise edition 15.11 can support a material number with 40 characters, and it explains everything. So see, the material number is extended from 18 to 40 characters. This is the same for all the other documentations. So you also have other documents like getting started and conversion guide. This is free. These are free documentation, free PDFs you can use to help you in your project, and they are very helpful. Now, if you look to other versions, so for example, if I go to the latest one, 19.09 latest. So if you open the simplification list for 19.09, it will show you the difference between 19.09 and 18.09. So every simplification list will show you the differences between the current version and the older one. So if you want to see the difference between S4HANA and ECC, you go to the first version, which is 15.11. So now if we go here, I also recommend that you go to the index. Don't try to go through the document without the index. It has a lot of details. So let's go to the index. For example, here we have a lot of things related to cleanup of orphaned objects, a lot of things related to ABAP. Then you have some Fury applications, some custom fields, changes in Process Observer. So again, you can go through this, and it's also by module. So it's separated by module also. So here you have material data management integration. And also if you go down here, you have commodity management, customer service, financial. So there are some updates on finance in 19.09 from 18.09. You can check them here. So this is in short how you can see the differences. You have the index. The index will show you for every area, like every module, what are the changes. And don't forget to check the master data, because this is a common area between all the modules. So this is it. Now you don't have to go and answer someone on the difference between ECC and S4HANA, and you get how complicated this is. So this is for 15.11, this is a huge document, guys. So when someone asks me what's the difference between SAP S4HANA and SAP ECC, I really cannot answer it. So let's see how many pages we have here. So this is a document of 269 pages of chain of differences between S4HANA and ECC. So giving you a simple answer would be unfair. It would be misleading. If you want to know the difference between SAP ECC and S4HANA, go to the document and see the parts you are interested in and read it. It is very, very important. This is it. I hope this was useful to you. I hope you find the answer you are looking for. And of course, don't forget to leave me your comments. Let me know if this video is good for you, and also share it with others. Share it on LinkedIn, on Facebook, and leave me your comments. And interact with me also on LinkedIn if you want. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to send me the questions. Thank you for watching. Stay safe, and I'll see you again in another video soon, hopefully. Thank you.